Well, I guess this will be your morning riot update, because once again, riots have erupted. In Lancaster, Pennsylvania, which is about 50 or 60 miles from Philadelphia, people began rioting after news broke of a man being shot and killed by police. And this story, this one's going to be really, really bad for the Democrats. You see, as most of you know, Joe Biden's campaign staff was bailing out rioters. Kamala Harris was soliciting donations for rioters. And this story is very different from the ones we've heard in the past. You see, George Floyd. Initially, we just had bystander footage. We didn't know exactly what had happened, and it looked really bad. And people said, yo, this looks really bad. Even Hannity and Glenn Beck, you get these conservatives coming out saying, why is he kneeling on the guy's neck? You then get the Jacob Blake video. It turns out this guy was fighting with the cops, but he still got shot several times in the back. So there's still an argument about whether or not he should have been shot in the back. Many of the activists started coming out saying, I don't care if he was, they were serving a warrant. He should not have been shot seven times and paralyzed. George Floyd, I don't care if he was using counterfeit money or doing drugs. They should not have held him down that way. Well, this man was running and screaming at an officer, swinging a knife, and it's all on camera. He comes out, the cop backs away, and the guy has a knife and starts screaming and swinging it, and the cop runs away. But the cop couldn't run fast enough, turns, shoots several times, and now this man is dead. And they almost immediately released body camera footage showing there is a screaming, crazy man swinging a knife at a cop. Not enough, I guess. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. There's no circumstance, because the rioters want to riot. They want to burn everything down. They don't have a cause. They are lying to you. They're trying to make you believe they have some kind of righteous morality behind them, but they don't. They just want a smashy smashy. I know. I've met many of these people back in the day from my, from being on the ground and covering this stuff. I know what these people are really all about. So now we have this. There's one video where this live streamer is saying the police, you know, essentially saying the police shouldn't ever kill anybody because they're not a judge, jury, or executioner, and it's better they die than defend themselves. No, no one would do the job. Oh, it's like, I'm going to serve a warrant. Guess I'll die. No, who's going to do that? That's insane. But now the political class is starting to recognize just how bad this really is. And I'll tell you what, I think it's going to be real bad for Biden. And Biden just tweeted out about gun control. The other day, some L.A. sheriff's deputies got shot several times in an ambush, and the shooter is at large. This is the rhetoric you get when these riots are allowed to continue, when the cop is the bad guy, even if he's trying to run away. Cop's the bad guy. All right. That means no matter what happens, you could have, I'd be willing to bet, you could have a crazed guy with a knife to the throat of a little kid, and the cop would be like crying, like, drop the knife, ah! And the guy's going to be like, I'm going to do it, and the rioters would come out and be like, they killed a guy, because they don't wait for the facts. They don't know or care. It is just an excuse to riot. Take a look at Chicago. Remember when that widespread rioting and looting broke out? They claimed cops shot a kid. No, he didn't. A guy drew a gun. The cops fired at him, I guess. The cops fired back. Some kind of firefight erupts. And then everyone's like, all right, excuse to riot. Let's roll. And there you go. That's the new normal. Let's read a little bit about Lancaster. And then I want to tell you why even the mainstream media, they're starting to recognize Joe Biden's going to hurt from this bad. From the post-millennial, they say Black Lives Matter riots in Lancaster, PA over shooting of felon who tried to stab at a police officer. Stab? I think he was trying to kill the guy. I mean, you can see he's screaming and running at him. Ian Miles Chong writes for the post-millennial. An officer involved shooting in Lancaster City, PA took the life of 27-year-old Ricardo Munoz on Sunday. The action prompted widespread Black Lives Matter riots across the Pennsylvanian city to demand justice for the man whom they claim was murdered by a trigger-happy police officer. The police were called to the area for a report of an in-progress domestic disturbance when Munoz lunged at the responding officer while brandishing a knife over his head. Body camera footage shows Munoz charging out the door of a home, knife in hand, in pursuit of a police officer who is forced to draw his firearm and fire at the suspect. They almost immediately released the body camera footage. I can't show you. It's brutal. But this poor cop, man, the guy's running at him and screaming. Police initially stated that Munoz was armed with a knife at the time of the shooting and promised to release body camera footage, which they did at 11 p.m. Eastern. But it wasn't enough to quell Black Lives Matter protest organizers who claimed that Munoz was a victim of police brutality. Munoz has an extensive history of violence. In 2019, Lancaster police arrested Munoz after responding to reports of a fight and learned the suspect stabbed four people, Local 21 reported. At the time, officers found Munoz holding a knife to his own throat and instructed him to drop the knife, but he refused and attempted to escape. Eventually, police managed to take him down with a taser. Among Munoz's four stabbing victims was a 16-year-old who suffered multiple wounds to his stabs to his face, thigh, ankle, and torso. His other victims included a 22-year-old female and two other male victims, both 26, all of whom suffered multiple injuries. There was no known relationship to Munoz and the victims, whom he appeared to select at random. Munoz was awaiting criminal trial for four counts of aggravated assault in the first degree when he attacked the police officer in the shooting on Sunday. Munoz's history of criminality includes stalking, repeatedly commit acts to cause fear, harassment, and criminal trespass. Despite Munoz's extensive criminal history, BLM protesters took to the streets of Lancaster on Sunday night to protest the shooting. A number of rioters damaged police vehicles. Now, of course, we had Elijah Schaefer on the scene. He says Lancaster, Black Lives Matter riots kick off in Lancaster, PA, after an officer involved shooting of a man armed with a knife. Over the course of the night, protesters agitated in the street and demanded that live streamers and journalists stop documenting their activity. Yep, no surprise there. In one instance, Black Lives Matter activists appeared to assault live streamer Franklin James Davis. Some protesters geared up in body armor and stated that there would be no peace and that they would get results one way or another. Now, I think most of you understand what a riot looks like at this point, so I'm not going to go through all the tweets explaining it. Let's just talk about the bad, bad news for Mr. Biden. Take a look at this from Forbes, from a Seth Cohen contributor to Forbes saying, what the Lancaster, Pennsylvania protests might mean for the Biden campaign. Protests? Yes, yes. Smashing up windows and creating barricades. I'm sorry. It's civil unrest and it's low grade rioting. Call it what it is. But this guy makes a really interesting point. And it's an obvious point. If these people are going to go out and riot after this video comes out, what sane voter is going to be like, I support the rioters? I said sane. Yeah, a lot of crazy people might be like, I don't care, F the police. But in this instance, what do we have? I mean, a guy was clearly trying to kill a cop and the cop was running. This is the crazy thing about it. I thought it was going to be like you'd see the guy run at him with a knife and you would go, no, and he would shoot. Nope. The cop actually turns and runs away. And I'm like, not only did the guy attack the cop tried fleeing first. And then when he couldn't run fast enough, that's when he fired. Come on, man. I do not expect cops just go out there and be like, guess I'll die, because cops would be dying every single day. And cops do die, but they'd be dying every single day. They're just walking out. Oh, I'm dead. No, they have to defend themselves. They do. I think reform makes sense. I think we can figure out ways to do better handle some circumstances. This ain't it. Look, I don't like that this guy died, but I don't like that he tried killing a cop either. So what do you want? What do you want anyone to say about this? The world is not a fairy tale where you can like magically freeze the man. Aha, I've subdued him. Sorry. Tasers kind of work like that. But when someone's running at you with a knife, you got seconds, not even seconds. You've got a fraction of a second to decide. What do you do? Well, this guy, Seth Cohen for Forbes, writes, on Sunday, an officer-involved shooting in the city of Lancaster, Pennsylvania, sparked anti-police protests that turned violent overnight. But unlike other recent shootings that have prompted national outrage, the facts of the case in Lancaster are very, very different. They also have significant national repercussions. On Sunday afternoon, Lancaster police officers responded to a call regarding a domestic disturbance. On arrival, the officer's body cam footage shows that 27-year-old Ricardo Munoz emerged from a residence wielding a knife and charged the officer in a threatening manner. In a defensive action in response to the apparent assault, the officer shot Munoz, killing him. Yeah, hold on. He runs first. He turns and runs. Later on Sunday, the Lancaster DA's office released a statement and video footage related to the incident, detailing the investigation that is already underway. Following the news of the shooting, anti-police protests broke out in downtown Lancaster. Sunday evening, and in the early hours of Monday, they turned violent, with numerous protesters acting destructively, building street barricades, and damaging the local police station and property. Lancaster police made repeated calls for calm, later confirming they used pepper spray to help disperse the crowds that had turned violent because they don't care about you or any cause. They are there to just destroy things. While the incident in the mid-sized Pennsylvania city may seem similar to other flare-ups of police shootings and anti-police protests across the U.S., preliminary reports show that the facts in the Lancaster and in Lancaster are very different. First, immediately released body camera footage shows a clear threat posed to an officer by an armed individual. Second, the Lancaster city and law enforcement officials promptly responded to the incident in a measured and transparent way, opening an investigation and releasing relevant video footage. In other words, the circumstance of the death of Ricardo Munoz is not, on the surface, the same as George Floyd, Daniel Perdue, and others. Yet the violent protests in reaction to the incident are the same as they have been in other cities like Minneapolis, Rochester, and elsewhere. And that's a problem for both the Biden campaign and the broader Black Lives Matter movement leaders who have defended anti-police protests as legitimate expressions of anger at unjust police actions. No, this was them doing everything right. Bad things happen. That's a fact. Grow up. Sometimes a guy will try to attack a cop, and we don't want anyone getting hurt. It's so easy for us to say, isn't it? How many, look, I'm sure there are some people are going to laugh and say, well, you got what's coming to him. No, I'm not going to say that. The dude's unhinged and crazy. I don't like people dying or getting hurt, but it's not the cop's fault. What's he supposed to do? They did it clean. They released the footage, and I'm not talking about the shooting. That's tragic. But the cop was panicked. He was running. He was being attacked. He did what he had to do. I'm glad he's safe. But the city did what was asked of them by all of these people. It will not stop. Black Lives Matter isn't seeking one simple change. It is not about reform. And so long as you have a man like Joe Biden willing to negotiate with these people, you will not be safe. What's that? No, Tim, you're wrong. You do trust Joe Biden? Let me show you what Joe Biden tweeted out. He said, "Weapons of war have no place in our communities. We need to ban assault weapons in high-capacity magazines." Okay. Assault weapons. Listen, man, because of the riots and the helicopters I heard near my house, I'm moving. I was trying to move for a while, but I decided to get away from these cities. Absolutely. I also decided to buy guns. And so did many other liberal Americans. I live in suburban Philadelphia. This is Democrat, like 80% Democrat. The district I'm in is deep blue. Deep blue. I went to the gun store. They sold out of ammo. They're sold out. They barely have inventory. They're selling everything like hotcakes. I always wondered about that. Are hotcakes, they sell fast? I don't know, whatever. But they're selling like crazy. And I'm in a blue area. I go into this store and I'm wondering, I ask, I'm like, are liberals coming in here and buying? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You kidding me? Because you know what? People realize something. You know, you can't just rely on the police, especially when the police are under attack. But that's the bigger point. If people are going to attack the police from a procedural level and physically attack them, well, then who's going to come and protect you? I remember during the New York riots, man. This is back in June. It's not even that long ago. There was a viral tweet from a guy who said fights were breaking out in his building, and he called 911, and the dispatcher said, "The city is under attack, sir. What would you have us do?" Yeah, what you gonna do? Oh, what's that? You voted for somebody who won't allow you to arm yourself? Joe Biden now saying let's ban guns at a time when widespread riotings are sweeping across the country, and no matter what the governments do, the protesters demand more, abolish, disband, defund. And it's happening. 129 at last count. Police departments got defunded in some capacity. Minneapolis, they're trying to outright abolish police. But you can't own a weapon. This is beyond bad for Joe Biden. Here's what I tweeted. I wonder how this will play out, considering we have record gun sales, particularly among more urban and suburban liberals. As the riots got closer to my home, I immediately went to buy guns, experienced how it works buying it, and now have completely flipped on 2A. Maybe it's a little bit of an exaggeration because I was never a staunch gun control person. I was always kind of like, I think we can have a conversation about it. And I'd actually talk to some instructors. Now I'm just like, nah, shall not be infringed. Get out of my house. I'll tell you, some people asked, What was the aha moment for you? The aha moment was when the helicopters and the sirens were outside. They weren't super close. It was probably several miles away. I could see the helicopters and I could hear the sirens. And I'm like, that's really close to my house, man. And I live in suburban Pennsylvania, in suburban Philadelphia. Lancaster is like 50, 60 miles away. Yeah, I'm not too enthused right now about what's going on in Lancaster because they did everything right. So what happens? What happens if somebody, some regular person gets accused of something and the cops do everything right? Let's say this. Someone breaks into someone's house. Homeowner shoots in self-defense. The cops rush to the scene. Everyone starts freaking out. What happened? How did this guy get shot? And the cops say it was self-defense. They say, lies. We want evidence. They start hounding and harassing the homeowner, attacking, you know, the building. And the cops just say, just arrest the guy, give him manslaughter or something. It'll be easier. It will be easier. We've already seen it happen. This is exactly what they do. There's a video that went viral of Caitlin Bennett. You know her. She's gun girl. And she was down at some college. And the cop said to her, you have to leave. And she's like, I didn't do anything. And they're like, well, I can't control this crowd. So you have to leave. And that's exactly how it'll play out. Do you think you'll be safe with Joe Biden calling for taking away your guns? No way. I would never vote for it. You know what? At this point, any gun control and I'm off. I'm out. I don't care about anything else. I just know that I've seen these riots going on for the entire year. I can't rely on the police for everything. I had someone try to break into my house. Now we have all these riots. They're getting close. Nah. I went out and bought guns. And I'll tell you what, New Jersey's got insane gun laws. It's ridiculous. Now, to be completely honest, it wasn't that difficult to buy. It just took a long time. It was extremely tedious. I had to like bounce back and forth between these different, go to this office, go to that office. It wasn't really that difficult. It was like a day of work. Then I waited 2 weeks. Then I got to go in. Then I got to go to the police department to get like the ID card. Then I got to go to the gun store. Then I got to pick out some weapons. Then I had to wait like a week or something. Yeah, it took a long time. There was a delay. And then finally, I was able to have guns. Now, there's like magazine capacity restrictions and things like that. But you want to have them come out there and say weapons of war have no place in our communities. Assault weapons and high capacity magazines. Yeah, I know what he's saying. But a federal judge just ruled in California that a 10-round limit is unconstitutional. So, Joe Biden, which side are you on? I'll tell you this. Not a staunch conservative, actually fairly liberal. But you know what? When it comes to my personal safety, I'm not playing games. Joe, you want to go and talk about banning weapons? I just had to go buy some because the people your campaign was bailing out are threatening the safety of my community. And I'd love to just rely on the police. I can't do that anymore because the people your campaign bailed out are calling for the abolition and the defunding of these police. So you want to come out and say, I'm for funding the police. I don't care. The people who work for you and the people you negotiate are not the people you negotiate with. So am I going to be confident with this guy coming in, Sleepy Joe, a little sleeping in his basement? No. Now he's the nerve to tweet about gun control. Are you nuts? Man. You know what's crazy about this? The tweet came after us. A lot of people are insinuating the tweet was trying to play up to the sheriff's deputies who got shot several times. Man, this guy had a gun. We need gun control. You think gun control would have stopped a maniac who wanted to go shoot cops? Are you nuts? No. I'll tell you what would have stopped that guy. One of the cops shooting back. I don't like any of it. I don't want conflict. I don't want war. But people have a right to protect themselves, and so do these officers. Gun control would not have stopped this man. He tried to kill people. Think about how stupid this is to say this right after all this is going down. No, I'll tell you what people are probably thinking. What would I do if someone runs up to my car with a gun like they did in Provo, Utah? Like the guy who came up with the assault rifle. Where was it? Austin? What am I going to do? Am I going to be in my car and a guy walks up with a rifle and I'm going to say, better call the police. Just a minute, sir. What about Provo? Am I going to pull up to an intersection when the mob starts banging on my car and go, just a minute, friends, I'm calling the police. I see you have a gun. Oh, I'm shot. No. People are going to say, I need to take action to protect myself from criminals. Joe Biden's lost the plot a long time ago. I don't even think he's had the plot for years. But how stupid do you have to be to at a time when we're seeing record gun sales, guns and ammo are sold out, and you come out saying we must ban these weapons? You mean the weapons everybody just bought? You mean the weapons I just went out and bought? Now you're saying that you want to ban all? Get out of here, dude. I'm not going to rely on you for my safety. Because these people don't care about the cause. They're pretending. They're lying. They're not protesting police brutality. They just want to burn things down. And that's why even after Lancaster did everything right, we know this cop was put in a difficult position and had to fight for his life. And I doubt he's happy about having to shoot somebody and the chaos that's ensuing from it. But look what they do. There's nothing you can do. There is no right way to do it because they will riot no matter what. And if they riot no matter what, then I want to make sure I can protect myself because the police won't make it here when the riot breaks out. Did anyone expect Lancaster, PA would be the next site of major riots? I didn't. And it's really close. It's not as close as the riots were before. You know, when the riots hit Philadelphia, I could hear the sirens because they crossed the bridge and they came into the suburbs where I'm at. And it was funny. It was really funny. I had a conversation with some family members way out in the far west suburbs of Chicago saying the rioters came out there too. And then I saw in the press, they said, Trump is lying. The rioters aren't coming to the suburbs. And I said, are you kidding me? I went out my deck and I heard the sirens. I could see the helicopters only a couple miles away. I have no idea why they came out here. But they did. What am I supposed to do? Vote for a guy who's going to take my weapons away? So what? I can just sit here. Guess I'll die. Yes. Yes, that's exactly it. Think about what they're saying with the cop. Like I said early on, the cop's got to show up. The guy comes out with a knife. And you better not do anything. The cops are just, here's my throat. You know, I just guess I'll die. What about me in the suburbs when you told me they weren't coming to the suburbs? And they did. And then my family calls me and they're freaking out. What are we supposed to do? Oh, the rioters here. I guess we're all going to die, everybody. All right, just you know, lay down, make it quick. No. These people are nuts. Joe Biden, this is crazy. I can't believe he'd post this stuff. But I don't know if it's getting through to people. There's like two different worlds going on right now. In one world, you have regular people freaking out because of riots. In another, they're freaking out because Trump said naughty words. I don't care. Trump could literally say every single, pull out a dictionary of cuss words and racial slurs and put his glasses on and read through them and actually point to people and be like, you're a fat pig and you. And I'd be like, I don't care. I'm not voting for Biden. He could say all those things and I will say, listen, I obviously don't like the man's rhetoric. I've already said it a million times. But what position, what am I supposed to do? Trump's the only one calling for ending the riots. I don't know, but I'll tell you what. You know, all said and done, you know what gets me more for Trump? These peace agreements, man. This stuff, my personal safety, I can take care of myself. I want to make sure this country is doing right by people around the world and our own citizens. And I know a lot of people, I'm not a staunch, might think I am. I'm not a staunch nationalist. My concern over foreign policy are the failures of the U.S. and the actions we take against other people. So I think we can do better. I think Trump is doing better. And I think Joe Biden's nuts to suggest banning weapons right now. How absurd. They're going to keep rioting for things like this. This is the new normal. So you need to protect yourself. They're rioting for a man who's running screaming at a cop. How insane. What more can I say? I'll leave it there. Next segment's coming up at 1 p.m. on this channel, and I will see you all then.